You might have all heard of the term allergic reaction and might even know that it can cause coughing, sneezing, hives, rashes, runny nose, scratchy throat, and so much more. But I'm guessing many of you haven't heard of the term anaphylaxis before. Well, the term anaphylaxis refers to an allergic reaction that is extremely serious and fatal. It can happen seconds or minutes after being exposed to an allergen. The most common causes of anaphylaxis are allergic sensitization to food, antigens that originate from peanuts, tree nuts, fish, and shellfish. Anaphylaxis happens when your immune system overreacts to something harmless like food. It might not happen the first time you come into contact with a trigger, but it can develop over time. In children, the most common cause is food. For adults, the main cause is medication. When you experience anaphylaxis, your immune system releases a barrage of chemicals that can send you into shock, resulting in a drop in blood pressure and constricted airways that prevent breathing. A rapid, weak pulse, a skin rash, nausea, and vomiting are a few of the warning signs and symptoms. To determine whether it is really anaphylaxis, you might want to recognize whether these three conditions are met. 1. An illness that develops suddenly within minutes to hours and affects the skin, mucosal tissue, or both. 2. Compromised respiratory system. And 3. Lower than normal blood pressure or signs of end organ dysfunction such as hypotonia, collapse, which essentially means a decreased muscle tone, fainting, or passing out. Now let's dive into understanding why anaphylaxis occurs, starting with sensitization against the allergen.
The immune system is responsible for protecting the body against harmful foreign particles known as pathogens. Pathogens are things like viruses, bacteria, fungi, and parasites that can cause diseases. We can think of our immune system and its cells as soldiers and pathogen particles as intruders. After the body's initial exposure to a pathogen, the immune system creates proteins called antibodies that recognize and bind to specific parts of the pathogen known as the antigen. Allergic sensitization can occur when the body mistakenly identifies a substance as pathogenic and produces antibodies against it. These substances are known as allergens. Like all antibodies, each immunoglobulin E or IgE antibody is specific and only reacts to a specific antigen found on a specific allergen. During sensitization, allergen-specific IgE antibodies are released from activated plasma B cells, which are the immune cells responsible for creating antibodies. The IgE will bind high-affinity receptors on the surface of mast cells and basophils, waiting for re-exposure to the allergen.
During re-exposure, allergens can enter the body through many different routes: inhalation, ingestion, and through the skin, to name a few. Going back to our soldier analogy, a sensitized person would recognize these allergens as intruders entering the body. However, because the immune system of a sensitized person has already seen this intruder before, it's already equipped with the antibodies that can quickly recognize and bind to the antigens. The anaphylactic reaction is then triggered when the allergen binds to IgE that coats mast cell or basophil surface receptors, causing cross-linking to occur between these receptors. This cross-linking causes mast cell or basophils to degranulate and release a variety of chemical mediators, the most important being histamine. Histamine causes an increase in heart rate and increased blood vessel permeability. This essentially means that the blood vessels become more porous and enlarged. These two changes allow circulating immune cells to leave the blood and enter the tissue site of re-exposure more quickly. However, through these effects, a high spike in histamine also leads to anaphylaxis. For example, the over-enlargement of blood vessels is what causes rapid swelling within the body. Swelling of the throat and airways can cause difficulty in breathing or even suffocation. Generally, the symptoms of anaphylaxis occur because the body is trying to remove a substance and mistakenly identifies as harmful, such as the allergen in this case. Therefore, symptoms of food allergy anaphylaxis can also include vomiting and diarrhea in an attempt to rid the digestive system of the allergen. Airway obstruction, inability to breathe, and choking are a few other symptoms of anaphylaxis, all of which can ultimately lead to death. So now you know one of the main pathways that is activated during anaphylaxis, the IgE-mediated pathway. Remember that anaphylaxis and allergies in general can be triggered through many different mechanisms, and this is only one part of the human body's complex immune system at work.